A different camp, different season, you know, and I think a lot of their philosophies will live on.
Mike's a well-respected man, and he's going to do a great job.
There's no reason that we couldn't win it again. I mean, other teams and other sports, and you know, it's happened.
Seen a lot of guys say, hey, you know what, I was here last year too, and I had something to do with this, and we're pretty good.
It is 2012, and change is definitely in the air. Same stadium, same name on the front of the jersey, but new manager, new pitching coach, and a new first baseman. The reigning world champions, the Cardinals, ready to embrace some new expectations. And welcome to Busch Stadium. I'm Martin Kilcoin, and welcome to this Fox 2 special, The Red Zone, as we set the table for the 2012 season. Back in 2011, from down and out to world champs, what a wild ride it was, with an entire town echoing Jack Buck. I don't believe what I just saw. But with the new season comes new challenges, and it didn't take long in Florida for the Cardinals to have a hiccup. Chris Carpenter and his nerve issues left the rotation in flux and a fan base unnerved. Carpenter didn't throw a single pitch this spring in game action, and there's no timetable for his return. Mid-May is probably optimistic. It was supposed to be the reunion of the two aces. Instead, with Carpenter out, Adam Wainwright had the stage to himself, and a year removed from major elbow surgery, he was on fire. Waino started the spring with 14 shutout innings, and he's given every indication he'll pick up where he left off as one of the best pitchers in the game.
I expect to have a lot of pressure put on me. I mean, I want to be the best there is, and if you're going to be the best, then you should expect some pressure to be put on you. So I feed off that kind of stuff.
And so right now, 100%, do you feel? I mean, everybody wants to put numbers on it. Do you just look at it as, hey, I'm the same guy, or I'm even better? Some guys come back better.
I'd like to think that I'm going to be better, but I know that this is a process, and I may have sore days during the year. I don't know. I've never done this before, so I feel great right now. That's really all I can say.
And this spring, Wainwright gave up just 3 earned runs in 18 and two-thirds innings. Rest of the rotation also sharp. Jake Westbrook, ERA of 1.50. Jaime Garcia and Kyle Loesch also kept the ERA under 3. Loesch's main issue was keeping the ball in the park. He gave up 5 home runs. Lance Lynn also solid, stepping in for Carpenter. Westbrook was the one turning a lot of heads with his pitching, as well as his leaner look after dropping 20 pounds.
I was the heaviest I've ever been last year, and I've lost some weight, and I just started eating better, and just wanted to be in the best shape I could possibly be, because I'm not 25 anymore, and just wanted to not have any doubts towards the end of my career here, and not have any regrets that I didn't do everything possible to be in the best shape I could be, and see what I can do here as I'm getting older.
And before the season begins Wednesday in Miami, the Cardinals with a little tune-up tonight down in Springfield, taking on their Double-A affiliate. And Maurice Drummond is on the road with the world champions down there in Cardinal country down south. Mo.
Yeah, Martin, it was an exciting time for everyone here in Springfield just to see the world champion Cardinals. It's also an exciting time for the new manager, Mike Matheny, and what a shift we're going to see from the manager ranks. When you're talking about Tony La Russa, who had 33 years of managerial experience, now handing it over to Mike Matheny, who has never managed in a big league game. But I got a chance to catch up with the Cardinal manager, and he told me about how he's getting set for opening day.
It's been a great ride. It was a great ride as a player, and now to be able to jump into this, it's all something that's been a great accomplishment without even accomplishing anything yet. So it's been a good trial with trying to make sure we're getting everything covered and make sure we're not missing anything for these guys. And you're going to keep hearing me say that, because I truly believe that's my goal, is make sure myself and the staff are ready to help these guys prepare and help them execute for the kind of season that they enjoyed last year. So that's something we're looking forward to taking off on.
Take me back to your press conference. You're putting on the jersey, and now here you are. What are the things that you've learned so far since the point that you were named as the manager of the St. Louis Cardinals?
Yeah, you don't have enough time for that answer. So you know, every day, and I'm I love to learn, and I think that every day I have this job, I'm going to continue to. And if there's a day that I don't, I probably did something wrong. So there has been so much. Last night I was on the phone with another manager, just asking more questions and making sure I'm covering the things that I should cover. And I think it's going to continue to be that way. But you know, we're getting there. We're getting there, and we've got a very talented staff. We've got a bunch of guys who know how to play the game. I mean, so it's not like we're starting square one and trying to teach them everything from the beginning. It's more of, hey, listen, how can we help you guys succeed again? What do you need from us to help you succeed? And we're going to do our best to put our part in.
At 41 years old, Mike Matheny, the youngest manager in all of baseball. Matheny also getting some leadership tips from Tony Dungy, the Super Bowl winning head football coach. And coming up after the break, Martin caught up with the two power guys, David Freese and Matt Holliday, two buddies who have been working out. These guys are a real couple cut-ups. You'll see why in just a bit.
All right, Mo Drummond live tonight in Springfield. Still to come here on the Red Zone, we'll check in with the two killer bees who now call St. Louis home, including the productive and popular Lance Berkman.
Having had the experience of last year and being in the city of St. Louis and kind of seeing what the Cardinal organization is all about, I feel right at home.
And we'll hear from Carlos Beltran, the three-time Gold Glove winner and six-time All-Star, making the move to St. Louis.